Stay tuned. Coming up next on Battle of the Planets. A space colony on the planet of Zebor is attacked by the evil villains of Spectra. Can G-Force rescue their friends on the space colony before Spectra totally devastates the small planet? Has Spectra attacked the space colony in order to lure G-Force into a deadly trap in outer space?
Standby team, I'm ready.
Will the Cerebonic superpowers of G-Force be able to overcome the powerful new threat to peace in the solar system? Be sure to watch this exciting episode coming up next. G-Force. Five incredible young people with superpowers. And watching over them from Center Neptune, Seven Zark Seven. Watching, warning against surprise attack by alien galaxies from beyond space. Young orphans protecting Earth's entire galaxy. Always five, acting as one. Dedicated, inseparable, invincible.
It looks very peaceful down here beneath the waves at Center Neptune, but as defense coordinator for G-Force, I'm always on the alert for sneak attacks by enemy aliens from outer space. Ah, that really hits the spot. It may not look as though I'm on the alert right now, but I keep my sensors sharp even while I take a 10-second oil break. Princess brought me back this vintage 10-4 from Venus. It's wonderful. It has that smooth body you only get from imports. I'm brushing up on the history of planet Pluto. That's where Susan is stationed. She's my counterpart who watches over the early warning system and alerts us to invasion. Did you know Pluto is 3,666 million miles from the Sun? 40 times as far away as Earth? That's really far out. And so is Susan. Seven Zark Seven, is that you, Susan?
Yes, Zark. I have a red alert. A mysterious UFO seems headed toward planet Zebor, where the space colony is located.
I'll get my scanners right on it. Thanks for being right on top of things, Susan.
It is my pleasure, Zark.
Well, well, let's see what's going on in outer space. Susan was right. My telecom is tracking that UFO straight to planet Zebor and the space colony. This could be very serious. I'd better alert security at once. I seem to be picking up something deep beneath the ocean of Zebor. I'd better alert the space colony so they can get to their bomb-proof shelters in case that UFO is coming from you know where.
My day of victory draws near. Soon I shall use my newest weapon to demolish the space colony built by Earthlings. This is the start of the great Spectra offensive, in which we shall capture every planet in the solar system and then the entire Milky Way galaxy. Beware, Earthlings! Your time has come!
The moment you have been waiting for has arrived, Zoltar. The Luminous One requests your presence.
Prepare your men and equipment, Pesca. I go now to receive the blessing of the Great One. Tra-la-la-la-la-la-la, tra-la-la-la-la-la-la.
You have done well, Zoltar. I am pleased with you. Is everything in readiness for the attack on the space colony?
Your loyal servants have done as you demanded, Great Spirit. The attack will commence as soon as you give us the order.
You are certain Center Neptune knows nothing of our presence?
Positive, magnificent one. There is no way their spy beams can penetrate the walls of this cave.
Then you have my permission. Attack!
I've informed Chief Anderson about the Spectra activity near planet Zebor. Now he has a very difficult decision to make.
Chief, aren't you ever going to tell us what's going on around here? Before we get too old to do anything about it.
We've been here for hours and you haven't said one single thing about an assignment.
Ruggle-dooty could go surfing.
I haven't eaten anything for over an hour.
Anderson.
The attack on our space colony has begun.
Are you sure that all the people have been evacuated?
All the people are safe.
We caught them off guard.
Come on, Chief. What was that all about?
I'll tell you what that was about. One of our space colonies is under attack. Let's go.
Stop. I'm afraid that Jason's right. The colony on planet Zebor has been attacked.
Then what are we waiting for?
I know how you feel, and I feel the same way myself. But you can't go yet. That call was the bait. They're waiting for you. It's a trap.
We'll just have to take that chance.
Chief, our friends are up there. We can't just sit here and do nothing. We have to help them.
Go by myself.
No way we're going to wait around here while Spectra's trying to wreck the space colony.
Go!
What's going on?
You're grounded, G-Force. At least for now. We can't risk sending you off to Zebor. I'm sorry.
At least the people had time to evacuate the city. G-Force must be very upset, not being allowed to go and help their friends. But the chief is right. Zoltar may have attacked the space colony just to trap G-Force.
A toast to the fall of another planet and to the capture of G-Force when they arrive. They will never be able to resist rushing to the aid of a stricken planet. My plan was truly a stroke of genius. That weird whistling, who could it be?
Pesca reporting, sire.
Never sneak up on me that way again. Now make your report and leave.
The traps have been laid for G-Force. When will they come, Zoltar?
Soon.
Good. There is no way they can approach this planet undetected.
Back to your post. I want no mistakes this time.
Sir!
Perhaps I should give G-Force a little more incentive to hurry them on their way.
Load ground borers. Ground borers loaded. Awaiting instructions.
Execute at will.
Execute at will!
Battery one, continue to fire!
I know they're taking a beating, and I don't like it any better than you do. But unless I'm allowed to do this my way, I guarantee we'll lose the entire planet. How much longer can I wait? By now, Zoltar must have relaxed his vigilance. And in all that confusion, it has to be now. We can't wait any longer. All All right, you're headed for Zebor. Let's gather round. If Zoltar is still waiting for you, and we must assume he is, he has to figure you'll be landing where the Phoenix always does.
It's the only place we can land.
There's no way we can come in on the planet's day side without him spotting us.
That's why you'll be coming in on the night side. No lights, no signal. Just a small strip within an abandoned tower. You'll have to do it all by feel, team. It won't be easy. You know how important this is. All I can say is Godspeed and good luck.
G-Force!
They're finally down. My triaxial synthesizers have been in quite a nervous state. I can't stop worrying about them. Not that they're safe by any means, but at least they're on the ground. Now the real work starts.
Doesn't look like anybody spotted us, Mark.
No, we'd have heard from them by now.
The abandoned control tower Anderson told us about. We're gonna need a home base. Maybe we can use that. Watch the glass.
I had to cut telecom communications for security reasons. And now I don't know what happened to Keop. But all the G-Force members have superpowers. I'm sure he landed safely with his cape wings. I just hope he didn't fall into a trap of some kind. I'm sure Keop is all right. He's a sturdy little fellow. I just wish I knew for sure. What really puzzles me is why Spectra would want to invade that space colony. There are a number of other planets with a lot more to offer. I've just got to see what's going on up there.
Where is he?
Keop, sound off. Where are you?
Here!
He's down there!
Down in cellar!
He's hung up on something!
Hang loose, I'll cut you down.
Keop, are you all right?
Been better.
Hey, look around. This place is an underground hangar.
Hangar, I understand. Why underground?
This wall sounds hollow. Let's see what's behind it. Hey, there's another room in there.
Another room?
Jason, get the drill.
Gotcha.
This must be Spectra's arsenal.
It's a great hiding place.
Not for long. Let's put this little hiding place out of business.
Let me do it, Mark. I love fireworks.
Hold it. Let's not waste this stuff. Maybe we can surprise Zoltar with a little present.
Flying Hotfoot for Zoltar.
You're right, Kia. Good thinking, Jason.
Wait till he finds these babies trying to climb into his lap.
Like to be there.
If you were there, Shorty, you wouldn't have time to enjoy it. You'd be too busy pulling out splinters.
Okay, Tiny, stand by the Phoenix. We're gonna check and see what else might be down here.
I always miss the fun.
It won't be any fun for us if you're not standing by.
It's not fair. Princess can fly the Phoenix, even Kia. And Jason never gets left behind. It's always me.
Now that he got that out of his system, shall we find out where this leads to?
Let's go! Men of Spectra, I ask you to join me in a tribute to the genius of the Great Spirit. I hold in my hand a victory. His plans for the invasion of the solar system. Our long struggle with the Intergalactic Federation is almost over. Soon there shall be no Federation, only slaves for Spectra.
Those plans.
Mark, we've got to get our hands on that cassette.
The fruits of conquest will be ours, and you shall all share in them. The Luminous One demands loyalty.
Sir. It's an emergency, sir. Somebody has broken into the arsenal.
Alert security. G-Force must have sneaked in unseen. Seal all exits. The rest of you, find them. G-Force again. They are like smoke. They appear and disappear like ghosts. Why does the Great Spirit allow them to torment me this way? I must remove them before they drive me to complete destruction. Whoever they are, and bring them here to me immediately. It can only be G-Force, but this time they will pay for the arrogance and pay dearly. Who's there? No one. There's no one there. There can't be anybody there. It is all my imagination. I am working too hard. I am beginning to hear things. No! Stay away. Whoever you are, stop that whistling. No! Stay away. It's a ghost! Mercy on me! Mercy, I beg you! I will give you riches, but don't take me!
So that's the flip side of Mighty Zoltar, afraid of ghosts. Well, your evil spirit can't help you now.
G-Force, will I never rid myself of these pests from Earth?
You can't, so just hand over that cassette and then surrender peacefully.
Fast.
The cassette? No! But there is something I do want you to have!
Has the cassette.
Princess, let's redecorate this place before we go.
Those miserable earthlings! Once again, they have thwarted our plans. How can I explain this to the Great Spirit? He will think I have failed him, but this planet will pay the price. There will be nothing left here but dust!
All batteries, fire when ready!
Zoltar is escaping.
Tiny, this is Mark. Let's go on the double. Those missiles you gimmick, Jason, when do you figure they'll go off?
Not too long after they're fired. They'll just turn around and head back for home.
Good trick, Jason.
Stand by.
Ready.
I think it's quitting time. How about we point this bird for home, Tiny?
Not yet, Mark. I'd like to stick around until those missiles I rigged go off. By now, Zoltar should be getting suspicious. The underground missiles are making a turnaround and will soon catch up with the Spectra ship.
Missiles approaching! Emergency! Emergency! Our own missiles are coming back at us!
Launch our escape ship!
Zoltar and his men got away, but they'll lose their main ship.
Bullseye!
We've done it. The space colony is safe again.
I don't mind telling you, for a while there, I was really uptight.
I guess Anderson knew what he was doing when he stopped us from jumping the gun. This ought to make him very happy.
I'll tell you what's gonna really have him jumping up and down. These plans for Spectra's invasion of the solar system.
You know what this means? We have Spectra right where we want them.
Look! The tape's on fire!
It's self-destructing.
Back where we started.
What a disappointment. But I can't forget the incredible job G-Force did in saving the space colony on Xebor. And while Zoltar did escape, I know G-Force will be there to meet him if he shows up again, anywhere in the galaxy. I wish I could go with G-Force sometime, blast off into deep outer space, far beyond Mercury and Venus. I'd like a showdown with Zoltar. If he tried to jump into his escape ship, I'd draw and throw. I'd cut his fuel lines like that. Then I'd capture the scoundrel and bring him in for trial. You're right, One Rover One. I forgot. I get air sick when I fly higher than this room. Oh, well, I'm proud and happy to stay right here and do my part for G-Force.